Hello friends, it's Vivek Moyal from vivekmoyal.in. Hope you are enjoying our videos. Please like and subscribe our channel so you will not miss any videos. Today's tutorial is all about how you can use webcam in PHP. Many times we need our users' images for our projects or our applications, and that time we need their images. What if they don't have any image in their PC or laptop? Here the webcam will work for you. With the webcam, you can click their images directly. No need of uploading the images from your local storage or your local PC laptop. You can also use it as a security guard for your home or office. Just place a camera and you can take the images at some time intervals, and it will help you to maintain the security. So the main question is, how you can use the webcam in PHP. If you follow my blog, then you know I have written an article around 3-4 years back about how we can use webcam in PHP. In that video, I have used a plugin which uses the jQuery and Flash to access webcam and click the images. I have also written the PHP code for saving that image to the database. But now recently I have written another article over webcam in PHP. This time webcam is working using the HTML5 and jQuery. No Flash at all, because many people were complaining about the uses of Flash because Flash is outdated technology. So let's start with how you can use webcam in PHP using HTML5 and jQuery. First of all, we will create a database, and in that database we will create a table. For creating a database, I will open my phpMyAdmin. Just a minute. Here I'm at my phpMyAdmin, and in this phpMyAdmin I will create a database that is PHP tutorial. I think I already have the database. Yeah, I have this PHP tutorial. If you want to create your database, you can go to server and this IP and click on the databases, and you can create a database here. Just enter the name of the database and click on create. As we already have the database, so we will create a table only. So I will create on the new, and here I will create a table by the name of webcam, and I will use only two columns. So one is int, one is for ID, and one is for image. And for the ID, I will give 5, and I'll make it auto increment. And here I will use image, and I will use varchar, and I will use whatever you can use. I'll use like 150, and just save it. So as you can see, we have a table webcam in our PHP tutorial database. So as we have completed our database setup, now we will move to our index page where we will show the webcam window and list of uploaded images. For the further working, I will open my blog and copy some of the code, and after copying the code and pasting the code, I will tell you everything, that why I use that code and what the code is doing. So I'm going to vivekmoyal.in, and here you can see my blogs are there. Yeah, here we have an article, how to use webcam in PHP using HTML5 and save image to database. This is the whole article of our video. If you want to download the working files, you can click here and you will be transferred to the GitHub page, and where you can download the files. So I will just copy this part. And here I will create a folder webcam. And here I will create a index file and just paste it here. As you can see, this is just a normal thing which we use in every pages. Like this is a meta text, and this is meta text, and this is linking of a favicon icon. This is the title tag, and this is the linking of our bootstrap CSS. So we don't have to create any styles because we will get bootstrap styles automatically. And this is a Jumbotron example of the Google that bootstrap. So here you can see that we have created a style for the camera also. Just let me run this first and then I will let you know. I'll just run this. As you can see, there are some problems. We'll just remove this part from here. And as you can see, nothing is visible right now because no JS and other things are defined here. So we will go back here. And as you can see, we don't have anything here right now, but we will just copy this part from here. And we'll just paste it here. Okay. But before working everything, we need our classes and we need our jQuery to access the webcam in HTML5. So for this, we will just download our package from here. I'll just download the package. Just clicking here and I'll just download my package. Or you can do one thing. If you don't want to download the package, you can just click on the page and you can see everything is written in there. Okay. But as we need the files for the video, we'll just download the zip here. And it's downloaded. Open the folder. Just cut it from here. And we'll move back to our here. And just extract to our page. And now, as you can see, we have our index page. And if we put this here, and we will just use the scripts only. We will put our scripts here. No problem. I will tell you everything that what I am doing and what is going on here. I've created just a folder JS for the jQueries. And as you can see, there are JS and other shutter MP3. So we will just copy this part and just paste it here. So we have the JPEG camera JS here. And now if we run this, please allow camera access prompted by the browser. As you can see, we have our, you can say the video box now. So we'll just close it right now. And now, as you can see, we have the images. We have the video of our camera. And if we want to click the image, then we have the buttons also there. As you can see, I will just run it. And if you run this script, always there is an instrument. I have uses allow use global default ask. So if I will click on this, you will see a block here. Use your camera. If you allow the, if you click on the allow button, then the camera will start. Otherwise it will not. If you block this, it will not start the camera. Okay. So let's back to our code part. Here I will tell you what is going on. This is just a simple body tag. We have created a container tag. And this container class style is coming from the Bootstrap CSS. We have created a div using a class called MD6. It will, as you know, Bootstrap is working on the grid layout. So this is just a grid layout CSS. This is for just center text. And This is for our camera info. And this tag is for showing the, these both tags will help you to show the camera. If we will just comment this and we will just start it, use your camera. And if we uncomment this and if we comment this part, nothing is working on. So this part is working and showing for the camera window on our page. This button will help you to take the snapshot of the camera. And as you can see, we have created an ID that is take snapshots and the class BTN, BTN success, BTN small. All the classes are coming from the Bootstrap CSS. And we have created another CoolMD6, another you can say another grid layout that is for showing the uploaded images, or you can say showing the clicked images. This is just a table tag, and the all the list all the images will come in the table body. Come back here. Now we have just referenced a jQuery using our googleapis.com, because these are fast and these are CDNs, so they are obviously much faster than our local script is there. This is the main script for showing the camera over our page and clicking the image. So as you can see here, we have created a script tag here, and in that script tag we have created a variables with options, and in that shutter org URL, this is the shutter org MP3 URL, this is the MP3 URL, and all the URLs are under JPEG underscore camera. And as you can see, we have a folder here, JPEG underscore camera, and this is our org, and this is our MP3. And this is the SWF URL. As many persons are using old browsers, so HTML5 will not work over the old browsers. So for using or you can say for running the camera over their browsers also, so we will use the SWF format. SWF format is the old one, our flash format. So if you have a new one, then the HTML5 will work. If you have the old browser, then the flash will work. So here we created a camera, JPEG camera, and we have created an object of JPEG camera, and this camera, and this camera is our ID of our dev. Options, every options we have defined here will go here. And if you open this part, JPEG camera, I think some files are more are there. Now you can see that we have created a button here. This is the button for taking the snapshot, and ID is take snapshots. Here we created a button click function using the jQuery. That is, if we click on the take snapshot, our camera will call the capture function and snapshot.show, and after the showing, snapshot will upload the API URL action.php. We will create an action.php here. We will create a file action.php. Now, as you can see, if everything done, the function will response send a response, and it will create a image list. As you can see, we have created a table row and then table column and image, and all the response is coming from after the process of uploading. And this image list is our table. As you can see, table body is image list. After the upload, this image list will prepend the tr and show the uploaded image here. If anything fails, it will show the alert that upload fails with the status and show the response code. And everything is done and will show snapshot is uploaded. So in this video, you can see that we have created a camera window and our camera is working here. As again, I will start my camera. I will just refresh the page and I will just click on the allow. And as you can see, everything is working. Our camera is also working. So I will just close this window. And now, as you can see, everything is working. In this video, you have just set up the camera process and clicking the button process. And in the next video, I will show you how you can upload the image to the database. If you have any question, please comment below. Or if you have any queries, please comment below. If you have any feedbacks, please comment below. Please like our video. Please share our video. I'm uploading another video for this. And this is the part 2 and the final part for the JPEG camera, or you can say webcam in PHP part 2. Thank you for watching the video.